Well, sister, and well, sister. What's become of my lord?
What's become of his servant?
Servant? He's a prettier fellow and a finer gentleman by 50 degrees than his master.
Oh, my conscience. I fancy you could beg that fellow at the gallows foot.
And my conscience, I could. Provided I could put a friend of yours in his room.
You desired me, sister, to leave you when you transgressed the bounds of honor.
Thou dear censorious country girl, what does mean? You can't think of the man without the bedfellow, I find.
I don't find anything unnatural in that thought. While the mind is conversant with flesh and blood, it must conform to the humors of the company.
How a little love and good company improves a woman. My child, you begin to live. You never spoke before.
Because I was never spoke to. My lord has told me I have more wit and beauty than any of my sex. Truly, I begin to think the man is sincere.
You're in the right, Dorinda. Pride is the life of a woman, and flattery is our daily bread. And she's a fool that won't believe a man there as much as she that believes him in anything else. But I lay you a guinea. I had finer things said to me than you had.
Done. What did your fellow say to me?
My fellow took the picture of Venus for mine.
But my lover took me for Venus herself.
Common Kent. Had my spark called me a Venus directly, I should have believed him a footman in good earnest.
But my lover was upon his knees to me.
Mine was upon his tiptoes to me.
Mine vowed to die for me.
Mine swore to die with me.
Mine spoke the softest moving things.
Mine had his moving things too.
Mine kissed my hand 10,000 times.
Mine has all that pleasure to come.
Mine offered marriage.
Oh, Lord, you call that a moving thing?
The sharpest arrow in his quiver, my dear sister. Why, my 10,000 pounds may lie brooding here this 7 years and hatch nothing at last but some ill-natured clown like yours. Whereas if I marry my Lord Ainwell, there will be title, place, and precedence, the park, the play, and the drawing room, splendor, equipage, noise, and flambeau. Hey, my Lady Ainwell's servants there. Knights, knights to the stairs. My Lady Ainwell's coach, put forward. Stand by, make room for her ladyship.
Are not these things moving? Oh,
melancholy of a sudden.
Happy, happy sister. Your angel has been watchful for your happiness, whilst mine has slept regardless of his charge. Long smiling years of circling joys for you, and not 1 hour for me.
Come, my dear, we'll talk of something else.
Oh, Dorinda, I own myself a woman full of my sex, a gentle, generous soul, easy and yielding to soft desires, a spacious heart where love and all his train might lodge. And must the fair apartment of my breast be made a stable for a brute to lie in?
Meaning your husband, I suppose?
Husband? No. Even husband is too soft a name for him. But come, I expect my brother here tonight or tomorrow. He was abroad when my father married me. Perhaps he'll find a way to make me easy.
Will you promise not to make yourself easy in the meantime with my lord's friend?
You mistake, missus. It happens with us as among the men. The greatest talkers are the greatest cowards, and there's a reason for it. Those spirits evaporate in prattle, which might do more mischief if they took another course. Though, to confess the truth, I do love that fellow. And if I met him dressed as he should be, and I undressed as I should be. Looky, sister, I have no supernatural gifts. I can't swear I could resist the temptation, though I can safely promise to avoid it. And that's as much as the best of us.